Good morning. As you know, I am Dr. Marco Mariola, and I am the coordinator of the course of Physics 151. That is one of the first video tutorial that we're supposed to do since of the coronavirus. So in order to stay close to you as much as possible and deliver our lesson, that is one of the way that we have to use. I want just remind you also that you can contact me with WhatsApp, and I also send an email to everybody about the Microsoft Team. I try to be present the entire day. Of course, if I am not available, mean that I prepare some other video tutorial or video class, and I cannot answer to you, or maybe I am in a meeting. But I try as much as possible to stay close to you. Another thing that I want to tell you is if you have some problem to connect to internet every day, but you have only a certain window of time to be connected, just send me an email and tell me what time you want chat with me. Otherwise, if you have more of this problem, send me an email. I can try my best to answer to your question. Now this is an explanation, this video, to explain the exercise number one of the tutorial number three. I decided to make this tutorial because two or three of you already asked me about this exercise, because the result that you obtain is not the same that is shown on the solution provided. The error is our error because there is a typo mistake, and in this exercise is missed one brackets. I decided to do this video tutorial particularly for that exercise because I want to show you how you can use the unit of measure to solve your problem. I mean, to see if everything is right. And in effect, if you look the units of the exercise, must be natural for you to see where the mistake was. Now, let's see the exercise. So, that is the exercise number one. As you can see, we have an object. The position vector is r, and of course, because it's a position vector, the unit of measure here must be a meter. And in effect, if you see here, you have 2.0 meter plus 5 meter per second and time, and of course the unitary vector that give you the direction of that component, so unitary vector I, so along x, and here along j, so along y. Now it is very easy this exercise because straightforward. By the derivation of r respect to the time, you are able to find the speed in vectorial way, so with the component I and j. And after that, you substitute 2 seconds into the final equation, and by the magnitude, you can find the right answer. Let's see now the exercise in detail. So here you can see that I rewrite the position vector of our particle. Now I want just show you briefly if I put together the component and the unitary vector together in one equation. So I just rewrite longer. So here you have r is 2.0 meter plus 5.00 meter per second time the time, okay, and the unit of measure is a second, okay, and also here we have the component I, the component I, plus 3.0 meter. Now the mistake here that probably a lot of you does, that you multiply the time squared by 3 and minus 2. And that is wrong. Suppose that I do that general mistake. So you multiply time squared by 3 meter. So if I do that, I have t squared. So here the unit of measure is a second squared minus 2.00 meter second squared time squared. So the unit of measure in that case is the second squared, and here we can put our unitary vector. Okay, now if we look at that, here we have a meter. The position vector must be a meter. Same story. Here we have 5 meter per second time the time that is expressed in second. And in effect, we can simplify second and second. What we have? We have 5 meter. So, because r in meter, that is correct. Let's see that now. If here we have 3.0 meter per time squared, and here, so we have second squared, the final unit of measure here is a meter per second squared. So you can see that doesn't make sense, because that should be meter like was for 5 and for 2. Okay, so in few words, the brackets is missed here. Okay, now everything works, and in effect, if I rewrite everything, I have 2.0 meter I plus 5.00 meter per second time t, that is a second, okay, I plus 3.0 meter minus 2.00 meter per second squared time squared, so mean that the unit of measure is a second squared. So now we can simplify that and that. So you can see that here we still have a meter, because you can simplify also that. Okay, so now everything is conform of what we need. So just to rewrite the initial equation, we have that the correct form is 2 meter plus 5.00 meter per second t unitary vector I plus 3.0 meter minus 2.00 meter second squared t squared j. Now we know that the velocity v is equal to the first derivative of the position vector respect to the time. Now we obtain that value is constant, so that it's a zero, okay, because that is a constant value. Here instead we have the time that the first derivative of t in time is 1, so we have 5.00 I plus. Now also that term is constant. What is not constant now is that term here that is a minus 2.00 time squared, but the first derivative of time squared is a 2 times t. So we have plus minus 2 time 2 t j. So the velocity as a component 5.00 I minus 4 t j. Now the next step, because t is equal to 0.00 second, we have that the velocity is equal to 5.00 I minus 8 j. Now because we will not want the magnitude of this value, we have that v is equal to the square root of the component in I squared. So we have 5.00 squared plus 8.00 squared. That value would be the square root of 25 plus 8 squared And that is equal to 9.43 meter per second. Okay, so now you have the correct solution of the exercise. So remember that here there is the error. Sorry, this one is the right equation. Okay, because if you do that you cannot do it. So let's say that that is the wrong one. I underline that so you can find the notes on Moodle. Perfect. Thank you to watch that that tutorial for that particular exercise that I suppose that somebody of you have the problem. So I hope that I resolve your issue and do also the situation. Please don't hesitate to contact me anytime you need. Thank you so much.